Hello, friends, and welcome to Championship Sunday here at the East Coast Games at the G. Forbes Elliott Athletic Center in UNBSJ in beautiful St. John, New Brunswick. This is your U17 boys final, and it is Basketball Nova Scotia versus Maine Basketball Report. This is going to be one incredible matchup. Both these teams look very convincing in qualifying for this gold medal game, especially so in the semifinals. MBR, no problems with New Brunswick. Basketball Nova Scotia, no problems with a Can-Am Elite. Nova Scotia, a very deep team. They are very athletic, can really get up and down the floor, put a lot of pressure on you. MBR only had eight guys, but all very solid, play outstanding half-court basketball, and a lot of size as well. Players to watch for Maine include Andrew Fleming, the big post player, number 32. Riley Robinson. And Jake Black. National anthems coming up. Alex Carson, Nate Darling, a couple players to watch for Basketball Nova Scotia. It's Nova Scotia and Maine. But first we pause for our Star Spangled Banner and O Canada. All right, stirring renditions of the American and Canadian national anthems, and we're ready to go here from G. Forbes Elliott Athletic Center, one of the great venues now for basketball in Atlantic Canada, this refurbished gymnasium complete with hardwood floor and new stands. Great seats, not a bad seat in the house. We're in the athletics or the fitness room overlooking the gymnasium, a great treat for students. They can get their workouts in and watch varsity action at the same time. We're up here at midcourt. Bill McLean with you, Drew producer, or Drew Demokis is our producer. You can reach out to me at B McLean Sports on Twitter. B McLean Sports on Twitter. Comments, feedback, shout-outs, opinions. Let me know where you're watching from, who you're cheering for. Nova Scotia is in blue. Maine is in white. And, of course, you can follow along with live stats. Go to ecgbasketball.com. Click on live stats. And you can follow along at home along with your webcast. Right away, Riley Robinson off the tip, scoring for two. And here is MBR. So this is Maine Basketball Report. For all you Atlanta Canadian fans checking in, they are an AAU school from Maine. And they have looked very, very good this week in competition so far. Had no problem earlier today with New Brunswick. Both these teams playing their second game today. They were on the floor at 10 o'clock to qualify this morning. But MBR convincing over New Brunswick, and Nova Scotia convincing over the Can-Am Elite. And there's one of the guys we were talking about in the pregame real briefly, Andrew Fleming. He had a huge game, 19 points against New Brunswick earlier today. He is a big man who can do it all, and real quick as well. And surprisingly outstanding elevation. He had a dunk in that game against New Brunswick, which may have been the best play of the weekend here on the main court. So 4-0 in the early going for MBR. Of course, basketball Nova Scotia, as mentioned, Nate Darling, a player to watch. Carson, number 13 also. Chase Tynes has come off the bench and played very well. There's Rowan Power finding Tristan Hyde inside, but no luck, contested by Fleming. And here comes Jake Black. Fleming right down the middle of the floor. Again, this is the big guy who can really do it all. There's the pass. That's way off for Riley Robinson. Had a clean look, but as soon as he let it go, it looked like the ball weighed about 2 pounds. Rowan Power on the take, and that'll be a foul, and if that's Fleming, that's a big first foul early on Fleming. They will definitely need Andrew in the game throughout its entirety, or most of it. Basketball Nova Scotia. Now it's going to be on Connor Moore. So the foul on Connor Moore. Nova Scotia has the full contingent, 12 players. And they will play all of them. MBR, 8 players. And of course, those three guys, very solid off the bench, however. So they have a very solid 8-man rotation. It's Jake Black. He scored 19 points in that win today over New Brunswick as well. Foul away from the basketball. That's going to be on Nova Scotia. So there's the first foul on Nova Scotia. That's on Tristan Hyde. So again, go to the website, basketball, or ecgbasketball.ca or .com, and click on live stats. And you can follow along with the stats at home. Connor Moore passes on the jump shot off the inbounds. Now in the lane, comes up heavy and brought down. There's Alex Carson. And that'll be a foul again. So Nate Darling, the rebound, quick outlet. Carson pushing the pace. And there's the second foul. That's one on Brendan McIntyre. Carson at the line. Knocks down his first. Knocks down his second. Four to three. Fleming, the handoff to Riley Robinson. Can't get it down to McIntyre. Here comes Rowan Powell. And good job getting back defensively. Robinson taking that away. 7:54 to go. Here's our first look at Isaac Whittem. Tristan Hyde. 16 on the shot clock. Nate Darling. Carson for three. Knocks it down. 5 points now for Carson. To lead all scorers in the early going. 7.5 remaining. No luck for Connor Moore. Nova Scotia has their lead, first lead at 6-4. Nate Darling lines up a three. Knocks it down. Nicely done for Nate Darling. And now 9-4. Nine unanswered. .709 to go. Ball up top. Whittem. Fleming. A good look at three for Hunter Smith. There's Tristan Hines, his first rebound. Or Chase Tynes, sorry. Chase can't finish inside. Whittem. Jake Black. Back up to Whittem. Ball on the floor. McIntyre to Fleming. Finds space on the baseline. He's a left-hander. Can't finish inside. Gets his own miss. Six on the shot clock. Up is Fleming. Off the front rim. Ripped down by Carson. And Carson pushes down the near sideline. Chase Tynes. Cole Pitts into the game. He'll get fouled. And we'll go to the line. It looks like Jake Black. Foul shot down for Colpitz. Two of two. So Campbell on the board with 2 points, and now 11 of four for Nova Scotia. Stretching this one out here. Picking up the dribble is Jake Black. Finds Tristam. Tristam against Carson. McIntyre the long two. Just rims out. Darling. And that'll stay with Maine as Darling couldn't keep it in play. Hunter Smith, McIntyre, swung around to Jake Black. Smith, he was really good off the bench in the game against New Brunswick earlier. Comes up short on that little jumper. 5:56, Nate Darling drives baseline. Help comes, and a foul again on Maine, and that's the fourth team foul on MBR with 5:51 to go. Substitutions, Cole Pitts out. And it looks like Kevin Vino coming in here for basketball Nova Scotia. First foul shot rims out for Garley. Second foul shot is down. 4 points for Nate. 12-4. This is a 12-0 run. Midway through this first quarter. Tristan finds a lane. And he'll get a foul on the floor. Joining us for the first game this weekend, the trend with the officials this weekend has been to make a lot of calls. Again, these are young players, so they're trying to make them, trying to help them play basketball the right way. And so every foul, every travel, double dribble, what have you, being called. So expect, if that trend continues, expect a lot of whistles in this one. Darling for three. 7 points for Darling. To answer the Fleming two, and now 15-6. Ball on the near side, cutting through is Whittem. Throws it up off the backboard, no luck. Here comes Darling with the push. Back towards the middle, a wide open look for Carson, yes sir! Carson for three, and basketball Nova Scotia, the bench erupts. 8 points for Alex, and 17-6 the lead. A 17-2 run. Mark that on your your game line. 17-2. The run in the first quarter. Our ongoing coverage of the Soccer Atlantics continues. in 2 weeks. This week we were in Moncton and Halifax. 2 weeks from now, we are in Corner Brook and Charlottetown. George Scott in Corner Brook. I'll be in Charlottetown for the U13 and U14 Boys and Girls Atlantic Soccer Championships. All four provinces coming together for a four-day competition. Always good times, outstanding soccer to be seen. That's the Atlantic Soccer Championships on Bell Aliant Community One. Go to communityone.bellaliant.ca for all the games. That's July 9th to the 12th. 8 points for Alex Carson. 6 points for Andrew Flynn. If this one starts to even out here, could be a real interesting matchup between Carson and Fleming. Tynes, the turnover, and the dunk. So Tynes creates the steal, finishes for two. It's 19-6. Tynes has been a monster on the defensive end, and there's that matchup I was just about to mention, Fleming versus Carson. And there's Fleming going to getting to the basket on Carson and drawing the foul. Going to rim out for Fleming. If there's one chink in the armor today for Fleming, it is production from the foul line. That's the first foul on Carson. Misses both. Gets his own miss, though. Nice pass to Riley Robinson. Gets his defender in the air and finishes for two. 4 points for Riley, so they will get 2 points. 19-8. Quick move by Chase. Can't finish inside on the boards. Battling against four main players. And that'll stay with Nova Scotia. Baseline inbounds coming up with a fresh shot clock for Nova Scotia. Nice look. Here's Crozier's first shot for three. Off the bench, fires up a three, comes up short. Fleming the rebound, the push down the far side. Robinson the pull-up jumper. Knocks it down. Nicely done for Riley. Give him 6 points. And now 19-10. So as MBR recovers here, that was a 19-2 run for Nova Scotia. There's Darling. And he'll get a foul coming up short on the scoop. But that's the fifth foul on MBR. Darling to the foul line. The first one on Hunter Smith. Knocks down the first. Darling now with 8 points. Rims out the second. There's Fleming. Fleming. Tough pass down the far side. Chasse wasn't expecting it. It scoots past him out of bounds. .345 to go. Darling nearly slips and falls. Gets it to Carson. Hunter Smith. All pushed down the far side. Out of bounds. It'll stay with Mate. Rowan Power back into the game. He'll sub in for Alex Carson. Up top, Smith swung around, Whittem. The entry for Fleming going against Crowsher. Can't finish, but he will go to the line. So Maine trying to stem this Nova Scotia tide. Anything Nova Scotia has also shown this weekend. They are a team of runs. They can go on some wicked runs. 41 points in the third quarter against New Brunswick. First foul shot down for Fleming. Eight points now for Fleming. And trailing, they actually trailed PEI yesterday at the end of the first quarter, 22-19. But that did not last long. And they had eventually won 116-47, I believe, or 113-47. Blocked shot for Fleming. Down to 8 points. MBR with a defensive stand. There's Fleming ripping through, getting to the basket, finishing for two. 10 points for Fleming. And now it's down to six. Times. Rowan Power, the floater, comes up short. Trouscher. Fleming influenced it. Battle for the ball. And a foul. On the scrum. It's going to be on Riley Robinson. And shooting is Nate Darling. That's the first one on Robinson. Crocher will sub back out. First foul shot down for Darling. Makes the second. 10 points for Nate. Back to an 8-point lead. Connor Moore has it knocked away. There's Fleming again. Vernell Johnson into the game. He's out on Fleming. Fleming gets the rebound up and in with the soft hands. 12 points now for Andrew Fleming. Well, we mentioned him in the pregame. A real treat for Atlanta Canadian basketball fans, a guy we wouldn't normally see. Get to watch him here in action at UNBSJ. There's a pass for Rowan Power. Hunter Smith, blocked by Vernell Johnson. Here comes Chase Tynes. Nice pass. Over the top, finishing is Kevin Vino over the top of Riley Robinson. So 2 points for Vino, back to an 8-point lead. 1:44 to go. Darling nearly takes it away. Goes out of bounds. Darling will sub out. And into the game is Alex Muse. Fleming finishes for two and one. 14 points for Fleming, and to the foul line. That's the fifth foul on Nova Scotia. And the first foul on Vernell Johnson. 15 points for Fleming. Down to a 5-point game. He scored 15 of the 19 here for MBR. Gets around on that, does Connor Moore. MBR has gone to a 2-3 zone. Scramble for the ball. That'll stay with Nova Scotia. 8 on the shot clock. So a 2-3 zone here for MBR. All up top. On the near side. 1 second for Rowan Power. Comes up short. And that's going to go back to Nova Scotia. So that's fortuitous for Nova Scotia. Maine couldn't secure. Now they got to set back up in that zone again. 18 seconds, Rowan Power. Kind of a 3-2 zone. And Carson makes them pay with a baseline three. 11 points for Carson. They make that a long two, so a long two for Carson. 26-19. Hunter Smith knocks down the long jumper. 27-21, and check that again. They again changed the score. thought that was a three. So it is a long three. Or a three for Carson. 27-21. No luck for Vino. Vernell Johnson. The rebound. And goes back up. And he'll head to the foul line. 6 points the advantage. Second foul on Connor Moore. First foul shot rims out. Second one down for Moore. His first point. Or for Johnson, his first point. Into the game again comes Campbell Kolpitz. He'll defend Jake Black. Shot clock is turned off. 18 seconds left for MBR. 13 seconds. They set up a shot for McIntyre. That would have been a long two. Smith on the boards with a tip play. Mentioned the hustle that he brings off the bench. Down to a five-point game. The heave by Kolpitz. It was online, but just missed front rim. And that's the way we'll end our first quarter. A five-point game here. This is a good one. Looked like Nova Scotia might get some big separation. The big storyline in terms of score, if you recall, 19-2. Some Maine fans. Well, we have Maine fans waving back home to us for you folks at home. So let's hope we can hear you, get you guys on the Twitter. I know you Maine fans are out there watching. We haven't heard from anybody out there yet in Maine. B McLean Sports on Twitter. To reach out to us, let us know you're watching down there. 28-23. But again, it was 19-2, the run for Nova Scotia, but Maine slowly but surely started to claw their way back after that. They got it down to a five-point game now. And again, you can check out the live stats at ecgbasketball.com. 16 points for Fleming, 4 rebounds, 5 points for Robinson. 11 points for Carson. Nate Darling has 8. Nova Scotia shooting 7 of 15. Maine shooting 9 of 22, 40% from the floor. Nova Scotia, 8 from 12 from the foul line. Both teams have taken care of the basketball. Only one turnover for Nova Scotia, 2 for Maine. And Nova Scotia out-rebounding Maine 9 to 5. That's a good job. Maine actually crushed. New Brunswick on the boards. There's a 3 for Nate Darling. McIntyre. There's Tristan Hyde back in the game. Got a piece of that shot. No significant foul trouble for Nova Scotia. Connor Moore has 2 for MBR. 9:31 to go. Hunter Smith quickly into the lane. Jake Black. Front rims at 3. Didn't quite have his feet set. But let it fly. In transition, Carson comes up short. And that'll go off of Fleming and stay with Nova Scotia. Alex Muse was in there. Darling, Tristan Hyde, Alex Muse, Kolpitz, and Carson for Nova Scotia. Moore, McIntyre, Smith, Black, and Fleming for Maine. Off the miss, here comes McIntyre. Right down the lane, goes at Muse and finishes for 2. Nicely done from McIntyre, his first basket of the game. 31-25, 8:55 to go. 8:45 remain. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Carson! And 1. Nicely done. Alex to the line. And back up to a two-point lead. Or an eight-point lead now. 13 points for Carson. Knocks it down. Nine-point lead. 14 for Carson. Fleming. The three ball for Jake Black. His first basket of the game. And that's a big one. That gets it back down to six. Intercepted. Hunter Smith, the dunk. A four-point game. Darling, guarded by Whittem. Underneath is Carson by himself. Defensive mistake there by Maine. And Carson scores. He's got 16. Nice look. Black up and under. Hunter Smith, give him 6 points, 36-32. Connor Moore now has three fouls as well. So make a note of that, Connor Moore with three fouls. Big collision there with Carson as Jake Black went flying in. And that will be a foul on Jake, a little rambunctious there. Carson, a little bit of a hobble there. Muse will sub out. Chase Tynes comes back in. The last lead that Maine had was 4-0. Darling for two. Back up to a 6-point advantage. Jake Black, Hunter Smith off the backboard, no luck. Darling the rebound, he looks to push the pace. Smith trying the back tap, no luck. Darling, Colpitz for three, nicely done for Campbell. Give him five, and right back up to a 9-point lead for Nova Scotia. Fleming, nice adjustment as Tynes came over to help. Can't finish, Colpitz the rebound to Darling. Darling, tough shot over Whittem. Comes up short. Maybe a little too rush that time for Darling. There's Connor Moore out here with the three fouls. Smith. Whittem for three. That's off the front rim. And a foul on the rebound against Nova Scotia. So that'll stay on this end as the first team foul on Nova Scotia. It's on Tristan Hyde, his second. So Tristan has two. Carson out, Croucher in. There's Whittem. Fleming sets the screen on Darling. Whittem, thought about a three. Baseline drive for Fleming. He gets pushed. And is that Tristan's third? The third foul for Tristan Hyde. So he'll need to sub out. Rowan Power will come back in. So there's your first significant foul trouble for Nova Scotia. Tristan Hyde has three. Connor Moore has three for NBR. Wide open is Hunter Smith. Tynes got out there, though, and really influenced that shot with those long arms. Rebound for Fleming against Croucher. Jake Black back to Fleming. He wants to go against Croucher. Gives an elbow to Croucher, and that's going to be a foul on Fleming. So the elbow is swinging a little too much there for Fleming. Croucher took it off the jaw. That's one way to stop Fleming. Draw the offensive foul with the elbow to the jaw. Rowan Power. A scoop shot for two. Power on the board. That's his first basket. And the lead now has ballooned to 11. And an 8-second call on Jake Black. The biggest lead has been 13 at 19-6. Darling up fakes on the three, step back from straight away, and is way off for Nate. And Krauscher unable to save it. .544 remaining. In their first half, there's Whittem to Fleming. He's quieted down since that explosive first quarter. Tynes into the passing lane. And that's going to go off Chase Tynes. Nova Scotia in complete disbelief, as am I up here. That seemed to clearly go off Jake Black. A good play by Black. And they are going to make the adjustment. Okay. So it will be Nova Scotia. Good help from the other official. But a good job by Jake to get back on that and create the loose ball after the turnover. Chase Tynes again causing havoc in the passing lanes. Wide open is Rowan Power in the middle of the zone. Cutting through is Darling. And a double dribble on Nate. I do have some tweets coming in from our friends in Maine. There is Fleming right on cue. Matthew Fleming. Great to have you with us, Matthew. Cheering on Maine, saying Andrew Fleming is a beast. Unstoppable is the hashtag. A three for Jake Black. 6 points for Jake. Kolpitz, the drive for two. Nicely done. Kolpitz has played well. He's got 7 points. Back to 11. Chase Tynes again. Chasing down the pass, leading Nova Scotia in transition. Kolpitz, the three. He's got 10. 48-34 is the score, and this is the biggest lead now for Nova Scotia. That's going to be a foul on Rowan Power. Fleming will go to the line. Looked like it was on the floor. It is going to be a Fleming went to the foul line, but that should be a baseline inbounds. It will be. Only the third team foul on Nova Scotia. The first one on Rowan Power. That was Nova Scotia basketball. We talked earlier about their ability to transition. The Chase Tynes in the passing lane. Leading the transition, Darling the push, the three by Kolpitz. Meanwhile, Hunter Smith knocks down his 8th point. Back to 12. 4:23. There's Power. And traveling. Sally. Thank you very much, Sally. Watching nephew Andrew Fleming play from Somersworth, New Hampshire. Thanks for broadcasting the game. No problem. You're very welcome. Our pleasure to be here. And great to hear from you in Somersworth, New Hampshire. Cheering on Andrew Fleming. .412 to go here. There is Mr. Fleming trying to get himself going again. Good drive by Black inside. And Jake now with 8. Down to a 10-point game. 4 minutes to go. Kolpitz, he's got 10 points. To Power. Tough entry for Chase Tynes. McIntyre was all over that wing entry. And that's going to be a foul on McIntyre. A little too rambunctious out there. Two fouls on McIntyre. .350 to go. Ball on the floor. Fleming. Behind the back pass for Smith. And thought about the 15-footer. McIntyre, the long jumper, knocks it down, and we're back to single digits. 48-40. Good take, Chase Tynes. Can't finish, gets his own miss. And goes up for the foul. 3:25. Now if you're back there watching in Maine and New Hampshire, you're starting to look at this foul situation. Again, you only have three guys on the bench. We're already in the penalty. There's a second one on McIntyre. Or the fourth one there, Connor Moore, sorry. So there's your fourth foul on Connor Moore. So they got to get him out. They'll get Whittem back in. So there's your starter, Connor Moore, with four fouls. Foul shot down for Chase Tynes. There's Whittem. Watched by Nate Darling. Darling gets a hand on it, creates the turnover, throws it ahead for Chase Tynes. Nicely done for Chase. Defense to offense again for Nova Scotia. And back up to 11. Jake Black off the back rim. Darling the long rebound. 2:55 left, 51-40. There's Rowan Power. Nice take for Rowan. Baseline inbounds. There's Whittem. And that's going to be a foul in the backcourt on Nate Darling. That's the 15th foul on Nova Scotia. So now they're in the penalty. And here's Andrew Milner about to check back in. We haven't seen Andrew yet. He'll check in for Nate Darling. That's the second foul on Nate Darling. So two on Nate. Still 2:42 remaining. And it's been a pretty long second quarter. Head coach of Maine, Rick Moore, reminding the minor officials to remind the officials that they are in the bonus here. So shooting is Whittem. First points for Isaac. Both foul shots made. 51-42. Andrew Milner. That's the double team at midcourt. Andrew Carson. Rowan Power. That's a turnover on Rowan Power. Both coaches have let the teams kind of figure it out so far. I don't think any timeouts yet. The deficit at one point was 14. That's the biggest lead right now for Nova Scotia. Down to 9. Whittem dribbling around up top. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Nice backdoor cut. Hunter Smith for 2. Smith for 10. Points now. As we say hello to Jim McMahon watching. The McMahons cheering Hunter Smith down in Alamonte Springs, Florida. Rowan Power. Chase Tynes the follow for 2. Back up to 9. 5 points for Tynes. But the McMahons watching Hunter in Altamonte Springs. Down there in Florida. Great to have you guys with us. Watching from Florida. 9 points. There's Fleming. They've got Tynes on him right now, and he is absolutely face guarding Andrew Fleming. I'm not sure if you can see it on your screen, but Tynes is, can pretty much guess which gum Fleming is chewing if he is. So it looks like Basketball Nova Scotia is taking that age-old approach of if you're going to beat us, it's not going to be with Andrew Fleming. Fleming was dominant in that first quarter. 2 of 2 for Jake. 10 points. And another foul on Maine. Down to 7. And that foul on Jake Black. That's his second. First one down for Milner, his first point. Eight points the advantage, Fleming the rebound. Again, make sure you go to the website, ecgbasketball.com. Click on the live stats to follow along. Whittem, nine on the shot clock. Mishandling is McIntyre as he made his move through the lane. Milner has it. Milner, nearly taken away by Black. Vino gets it back from Carson, fires a three. Off the bottom of the front rim and taken away by Hunter Smith. Just over 50 seconds remaining. McIntyre trying to drive past Tynes. He does. Gets a step on Tynes over the top of Power. Three Nova Scotia players were there, including Power, Tynes, and Carson. And McIntyre finishes with a left hand. That'll get it down to six. And the foul is going to be on Rowan Power. It's his second. And McIntyre now with 6 points. He'll go to the line to try to make it seven. Crousher will check back in for Power. Colpitz will come back in for Chase Tynes. That rims down for McIntyre. And back down to a 5-point game. Fleming will check out. We'll try to get him an extended break here with halftime coming up. If you're first time joining us this week, 10-minute halftimes. There's Carson taken away by Connor Moore. And I checked my live stats. They had Connor Moore with four fouls on the board, so they could be rolling the dice here with Connor. Whittem. Chasse. Quickly swung around. 10 on the shot clock for Whittem. Up top is Moore. 4 on the shot clock. Robinson has to fire it up. 1 second. Gets it off. Rims off. And Crousher the rebound. Pressure from Maine in the backcourt. 10 seconds to go. Up ahead. Carson to the basket. He'll finish for 2 and 1. And that could be the third foul on Jake Black. So that's a tough call for Maine. 5 seconds remaining. Carson scores. And that might be the third foul on Jake Black. It is. 3 fouls on Jake. And up to an 8-point or 8-point lead again on the 3-point play by Carson. Robinson wanted a foul, no call. Maine fouls irate. They thought there should have been a call on that. But that's the way we'll end our first half. A tough break for Maine as they battle back to get it within 5. But Nova Scotia breaks that pressure after the missed Maine basket. Get it up to Carson. He gets the 3-point play. Jake Black picks up his third foul. And an 8-point lead for the Blue Nosers here at the end of the first half. So thanks for being with us. You're on Bell Aliant Community One, the leader in local sports webcasting in Atlantic Canada. A great matchup here in our gold medal game. And really not just a great matchup of two outstanding basketball teams, but you also have, obviously there's the affiliation with New Brunswick and Nova Scotia as we're sister provinces here in Atlantic Canada. And many times have met on the basketball stage. But also you have a team from Maine, and of course here at UNBSJ especially, there has been a real rich history with teams here at UNBSJ and from St. John traveling. One of my buddies, Dave Shields, a coach here in the area, he's a big Duke fan. He's showing me the Duke logo on his jacket. But anyways, there's a real rich history here between UNBSJ and Maine basketball, either competing in the small college league there in Maine or teams from St. John playing exhibition games. But you could argue that the history between UNBSJ and Maine, even probably richer than teams from Nova Scotia. So really outstanding that we have a team from Nova Scotia and a team from Maine in the final here for this inaugural East Coast games you're watching on Bell Aliant Community One. Some real quick shout-outs on Twitter. Jim McMahon, shout-out to you guys, cheering on Hunter Smith, and from 9-year-old cousin Amelia out there. Hello out there to Amelia watching down in Florida. Great to have you guys with us. So again, B. McLean Sports on Twitter. Great to hear from some fans watching in Maine. Of course, I know you, all you fans in Nova Scotia are watching as well. Hope to hear from you. Reach out to me at the Twitter handle on the screen. And also make sure you follow ECG Basketball. And go to the website ecgbasketball.com to follow along with the live stats. All right. Let's take a quick break here. Back in about 5 minutes to get you ready for your third quarter. It's 57-49. Basketball Nova Scotia leading Maine at the half on Bell Aliant Community One. right, friends, welcome back to the G. Forbes Elliott Athletic Center right here at UNBSJ. In St. John, New Brunswick, these are the East Coast games, and we are at the basketball venue finishing off an incredible weekend for the East Coast games here in the city. We have rugby, softball, lacrosse, track and field, all going on this weekend. Soccer, and brought thousands of athletes and fans and parents, families into the area. About five or six different venues across St. John. And we're finishing up with basketball, and we got a good one here. This is Maine versus Nova Scotia, and a 8-point lead right now for basketball in Nova Scotia. 19 points for Alex Carson, 13 points for Campbell Colpitz. I hit in for 10, so 13 for Campbell Colpitz. 10 for Nate Darling, 7 for Chase Tynes to lead Nova Scotia. 16 points for Fleming. That was all in the first quarter, though, so they're going to try to get him going again. Tough shot there. I think they've started to play off Fleming a little bit and make him have to shoot the ball. Rowan Power, no luck, but there's the follow for Darling. So Darling now with 15. Or Darling now with 12, sorry. There's Smith, Fleming again. Double team comes from Darling, spins free of it, finds Riley Robinson, the up fake, and he'll get a foul. Fleming with 16, Jake Black has 13. And 7 points for Brendan McIntyre. MBR is shooting 19 of 38 from the field. First foul shot down for Riley Robinson. Nova Scotia shooting 18 for 33, so both teams shooting well. Nova Scotia shooting 9 for 14 from beyond the arc. That's staggering. 65% from beyond the arc for Nova Scotia. So that's your major difference right now. 8 points for Riley Robinson. 9 minutes remaining in the third. Carson, Colpitz, straight away three. 16 points for Campbell Colpitz. And now 10 for 15 is Nova Scotia from beyond the arc. There's Jake Black to Fleming. He's going to try to drive on Tristan Hyde. The crossover, help comes, and he'll get a foul, I believe, on Tristan Hyde. And if so, that would be Tristan's fourth. You have three fouls now on Darling as well. Chase Tynes getting ready to come back in. And the foul on Power. So the foul on Rowan Power. That's his third. So three on Power, two on Hyde. Two now on Darling. Check that, two on Darling going by the live stats. One out of two on the foul shots. Four fouls for Jake Black. They got Jake Black for four fouls. That can't be right. Not sure the live stats are correct. That was Connor Moore had four, I believe. Jake's out there. If it is Jake out there, or if it is Jake with four, he's out there on the floor right now. But so is Connor Moore. Again, Maine only has eight players. Not a lot of options. Nice job by Connor getting down on the pass. McIntyre out of bounds. So both teams battling foul trouble. All down the near side. Riley Robinson, there's Fleming. Robinson again, back towards the defense. The three for Jake Black. Short, good hustle play by McIntyre. Gets it to Fleming. Still 8 seconds on the shot clock. Jake Black fires for three. Off the front rim. And here's a rebound foul on Tristan Hyde. So another foul on Hyde as him and Fleming were battling. That's the fourth foul on Tristan. 62-52, four fouls on Hyde. And Tristan's still out there. McIntyre, no luck. 7:47 remaining. There's Campbell Colpitts. Taken away by Fleming. Good anticipation there by Fleming, but then stepping in was Darling. He causes the travel on Riley Robinson. 62-52. So again, on this big scoreboard, they have four fouls for Tristan Hyde, but the coaches don't have anybody out to substitute, so they'll have Hyde still out there. Darling drives through the lane. The runner nicely done for Darling. 14 points. Lead back up to 12. Connor Moore. He'll finish inside and one. And based on what the score clock has, if that's on Tristan Hyde, that's his fifth. That gets it down to 10. And they've got five fouls on Tristan Hyde. And now they're trying to blow the play down. The foul shot was missed. They have five fouls on Tristan Hyde on the score clock. And that's it for Tristan. So Tristan will foul out with 7:25 remaining. Tristan Hyde, your first casualty. They'll bring in Chase Tynes for him. A lazy pass by Tynes, intercepted. Connor Moore takes it in for two. So nothing on that pass from Chase Tynes. Connor Moore intercepts it. A little scoop shot for two. And a four-point run. We're down to an eight-point lead for Nova Scotia. Tynes on the far side. There's Darling. Crossing over on Jake Black. Kicked out for Crosher. One more pass for Colpitts. And 19 points now for Campbell on another three. 67-56. Fleming. Going against Carson, crossing over on him. Wants to hand off, he will, to McIntyre. Jake Black. Fleming. Nice look for McIntyre for two. 8 points for McIntyre, 67-58. Four team fouls for Nova Scotia in this quarter. None for Maine. Chase Tynes. Short on the three. Punches it ahead. Tynes is there to pick up the loose ball. Attacks the basket. Darling steps on the end line as he made his move. Robinson. Chasse will check back in. Jake Black. Going against Colpitts. Able to get it off to Connor Moore just before he touched back down. Fleming strong to the basket, can't finish inside, and here comes Darling. The rebound and push. Gets past Moore and then goes sliding down, and that'll be a travel on Darling. Darling saying he got fouled. Maine throughout this entire game has been right on that cusp of making this a one or two possession game. They've got it down to five. Again, they led 4-0 in the early going, but then a 19-2 run for Nova Scotia. And since then, they've been battling back, but Nova Scotia always seems to have the answer. And again, they do. nicely done on the play with Kevin Vino. 69-58, back up to double digits. Hunter Smith, catch and fires a three. Nicely done. Hello, Florida. Hunter Smith for three. 13 points now. Darling gets hit by Jake Black. And now we're talking about that, who had four and who had three. Live Stats had Jake for four. I had three on Black in there. So Live Stats was wrong in that one time. That is the fourth foul on Jake Black. So I think they just have Connor Moore and Jake Black mixed up there. Because I believe Connor Moore has four. So the fourth foul on Jake. Darling knocks down all three. 17 points now for Darling. Black will sub out. Running the baseline. Kachasek. Pressure. Looking to double. They got to get it over. 17 seconds. They will. Nicely done by Chasse. McIntyre. Guarded by Milner. Fleming drives the lane. Tough shot. That's up and in for Fleming. His first basket since the first quarter. Now is 18. Back to nine. Backdoor cut. Milner inside for two. Nicely done for Andrew. Up to 3 points now. Back to 11 is the lead. Milner's first basket of the game. Fleming. Nice look for McIntyre. High-low passing. 10 points for McIntyre. 4:20. Kevin Vino. Darling up fakes. And traveling on Nate Darling. Just over 4 minutes left. Hunter Smith poked away by Darling. Smith diving on it. Can't pick it up. Now here comes Fleming. They still have 16 on the shot clock. Fleming with a head of steam. And a foul on the floor. That worked out well for Maine. Fleming is able to chase it down and then get out into the open court with the dribble. And that got him some steam going towards the basket. A foul on the floor. That's the first foul on Milner. Five team fouls now on Nova Scotia. Fleming to the line. With 17 points for Darling. 19 points for Colpitz. Carson has 19. Fleming now with 21. Misses both. So obviously that's what the big fella has to work on. Knocking him down from the foul line. Darling. Milner, short on the three. Nice play by Vino to keep it alive to Carson. 3:42 left. Carson trying to get a step on Fleming. Nice look for Vino. Finishes before the defense could get there. 76-65, back to 11. They've exchanged, just going back and forth between 9 and 11-point leads right now. Connor Moore, the long jumper. Can't roll in. Tip back to McIntyre. Hunter Smith for three. Knocks it down. 16 points for Hunter Smith. To an 8-point game. 3:10 left. Crozier. No luck on the drive. Taken away. Here comes Cache. Fleming gets a step. And he'll get a foul on Carson on the body. Fleming back to the foul line. Croucher out, Darling out, Tynes and Cole Pitts come back in. The second foul on Alex Carson. Let's see if Fleming can knock these down. Misses the first. Knocks down the second. The lead down to seven. Milner crossing over on McIntyre and then gets through the hands of Vino. He says it went off a main player. .252 left. Here comes Fleming. Behind the back pass for McIntyre. He thought McIntyre was going to sit out there at the three-point line. But again, McIntyre was driving towards the basket. That sails out of bounds. 2:46 left. Cole Pitts on the far side. Crossing over. Guarded over there by Witham. Carson knocked away by Connor Moore. Moore fell. The three by Cole Pitts finally missing. And that'll be a foul on Carson trying to knock it away from Hunter Smith. That'll be the third on Carson. So a costly one there on Carson. Probably should let that one go. Should Carson. He's now has three. Now Hunter Smith struggling from the foul line. This is a main team that now is shooting 12 of 22 from the foul line. 13 of 23 on the foul shot there for Hunter. Smith now with 17 points. But that's a 6-point, there's a 6-point difference, and if they're shooting at a decent, normal, healthy percentage, this game would be tied. Smith the rebound. And thrown away on the pressure after the rebound, and then, and one! Nova Scotia forces the turnover. Cole Pitts goes strong and gets the foul on McIntyre. Cole Pitts is having himself a game. That's the third foul on McIntyre as well. 22 points now for Cole Pitts. Make it 23. Back to a 9-point lead. And the skip pass that finds the stands. And with 2 minutes remaining, Nova Scotia looking to get it back to double digits. Colpitz. Milner. A wide open Muse. Tynes and Colpitz from straight away. Another three for Colpitz. 26 points for Campbell. The lead is 12. They break the pressure. McIntyre for two. 12 points for McIntyre. Back to a 10-point game. Chase Tynes lines up a three. Knocks it down. 8 points for Chase. The lead is 13. McIntyre splits the pressure. And then a foul as he attempted the pass. McIntyre knocks down the first. 85-74. 14 points for McIntyre. This game destined for the hundreds. 85-74 as we approach the end of the third quarter. Milner for two. 5 points for Milner. Riley Robinson. Hunter Smith gets a screen from McIntyre. Back to Robinson. Nova Scotia still in the man-to-man. The long jumper for Fleming. Knocks it down. It's a big jumper for Fleming. Try to make them get out on that jump shot. 24 points for Andrew. Rowan Power aggressively over the top of Fleming for two. Back to a 13-point lead, 89-76. Way down the floor by himself is Hunter Smith. He'll catch and shoot a long two. Back rim, and Robinson unable to keep it alive. Here comes Tynes and Cole Pitts. Cole Pitts decided to take it himself. And that is out of bounds off of Maine. Tynes really wanted that. Was hoping for the alley-oop pass. Nova Scotia will call a timeout and set up a shot. Shot clock's turned off. B. McLean Sports on Twitter. Thanks to everybody who's reached out so far. Comments, feedback, shout-outs. Let us know where you're watching from. Who you're cheering for. Great to hear from you folks down there in Maine and Florida and New Hampshire. Great to have you with us in St. John, New Brunswick. UNBSJ here at the beautiful G. Forbes Elliott Athletic Center. Nine seconds on the clock. Baseline inbounds for Colpez. Here we go. Tough inbounds pass, and Tommy McGrattan. Let's say it went back or goes back to Maine. Somehow 5 seconds came off the clock, and the coach of Maine just realizing it. No way 5 seconds went off the clock there. So that's what Maine fans are saying. How did 5 seconds just come off the clock? I'd say at the very least 1 second at the most. I'll put it right back to nine. So I'm going to put it back to nine. Well, Maine has a 9 seconds to try to set something up here. The Maine coach wants to call a timeout, Rick Moore. Checking with the referees what the proper indication is for up here in Canada for the short timeout. So Coach Moore calls timeout, and he'll try to set something up here with 9 seconds. And a great matchup here again of two areas. Again, Nova Scotia, of course, the long-time heated competition with New Brunswick in basketball, and a team from Maine, of course, who has the rich basketball tradition here with teams from St. John, and especially here at UNBSJ. All right, so 9 seconds to go. I'll do it again. It's a weird entry point as well, or inbounds. Far side, almost near the corner. They got to get it off. They won't. Oh, my. Can't get it off in 5 seconds. Mention how it was a weird angle, and they just could not find an angle for a pass. And now there's still 9 seconds on the clock, and Nova Scotia will try it. And here's our third inbounds. It's in. Colpitz off his foot. Chase Tynes, up fix, step back, three. Off the backboard, knocks it down, and what a turn of events that was. Man, oh man. Instead of Maine, with 9 seconds, maybe trying to drive down for the final shot, they can't get the ball inbounded. Chase Tynes, the three off the backboard as time expires, and up to a 16-point lead when all is said and done as we head to the fourth quarter. So that may be the decisive moment in this one. Possibly a 5 or 6 point swing there. Tynes knocking down the three. All right, so you're, let's see, these are updated. With the three by Hines. Chase now has 13 points. So 13 points for Tynes, 7 for Vino, 5 for Milner, all off the bench. 24 points for Colpitz. So 24 points for Colpitz. This is on the live stats. 19 for Carson, 15 for Darling. Campbell Colpitz is 6 for 6 from beyond the arc here on the live stats. So 6 for 6, 8 for 9 from the field. That's a staggering stat line for Campbell. Another staggering stat line, Nova Scotia is shooting 30 of 48, to actually make that 31 of 49. 31 of 49 from the field. 15 of 23 from beyond the arc for 92 points after three quarters. Unbelievable. Fleming has 25 points, 6 rebounds. I mean, Maine is shooting really well too. Maine's shooting 28 for 54, 51%. Any given day, that would have you either up by a bunch or at the very least within 5 or 6 points. Fleming has 25, as mentioned. McIntyre has 15. There's a jumper for Connor Moore. Give him 6. Jake Black has 13, and Hunter Smith has 10. So 10 for Hunter Smith. And that is live stats. I've got Hunter with 17. I think he has way more than 10. Rowan Power for three, and now 17 points is the lead. This is the biggest lead of the game for Nova Scotia. That jumper is short by Jake Black. And we'll see if this 8-man Maine team can summon up one more charge. Milner. Up to 19 now on the basket by Milner. Black crossing over. Into the lane. Nicely done for Jake Black. Jake out there playing with 4 fouls. So 97 to 80. The 3-point play for Black. 97-81. Darling knocks down the three. Back to 19. And the three by Darling. 8:30 to go. Hunter Smith misses the turnaround. And here comes Nate. Alex Carson. Milner, the straightaway three, off back iron. Rebound for Connor Moore. Fleming. Coming up short on the jumper. Darling crossing over. Quickly through the lane and with the right hand for Nate. Nicely done. 102 to 81. Fleming for three. 102 to 84. On the baseline. Carson. Kolpitz, that's his first miss from beyond the arc. Got a hustle play by Milner. He'll get the foul. Or draw the foul. .723 to go. Carson. Second foul on Hunter Smith. Nice take for Darling. Can't finish. Jake Black to Fleming. He'll fire another three. Just off the front of the rim. 102-84. Jake Black picks the pocket of Milner and finishes for two. 102-86. And the comeback formula in this situation, you're always trying to get, not always, but a nice guideline is to get within 10 points with 5 minutes remaining. Nice play, Milner. Darling for three. Milner, the steal. Leads to the three for Darling. 105-86. Back to 19. Fleming. Jake Black for three. That is way off for Jake. And just as we found in the girls U17 game where New Brunswick basketball, New Brunswick had 12 players and St. Thomas only had eight. As this fourth quarter wears on, you start to see the legs getting real heavy on this main team. And the shoulders are dropping, hands on hips. Nova Scotia going 12 deep. And they are starting to wear down MBR. That's a fourth foul on McIntyre. .106-87. Hunter Smith, short on the three. Carson, Milner, and Rowan Power pushing. Darling, the three in transition, comes up short. Carson! Says he saved it, but referee says he stepped on the end line. Smith. Tipped away from Jake Black, and here comes Rowan Power in transition. Chase Tynes. A hard foul by Hunter Smith. Tynes goes flying. He's okay. A foul on Smith. Tynes to the foul line. First foul shot down. .108-86. Milner. Inside. And now up to 24 points is the lead. Ball thrown away. Another possession for Nova Scotia. And this one is going to go to the Blue Nosers. They will start slowly turning into a coordination here. Basketball Nova Scotia. Looking very much like they will be the inaugural recipients of the gold medal here at the first ever East Coast Games. Nate Darling comes up short. Hustle rebound for Rowan Power. Power splits the defense. The follow for Chase Tynes on the mystery by Carson. 26 points the lead now. This one is really stretching out. Fleming finishes inside. Nicely done for Andrew. 4.5 remaining, 112-88. Power will get the foul and go to the line. At one point, Maine got to within 5 points in this extended comeback effort after the 19-2 run for Nova Scotia in the first quarter. For a long time, kept it around 7, 8, 9, that area. They just could not get to within one possession. Now Nova Scotia really stretching it out. Rowan Power knocks down the first. Knocks down the second. 4:25 to go. Tynes into the passing lane, nearly gets it. Black fires the three, misses. Tynes out in front. And Chase couldn't quite get to the rim. Lays it in over the top. 116-88. Fleming just misses the throw down. He threw, as mentioned earlier, he threw one down earlier today against New Brunswick. That was just filthy. .346. Rowan Power on the far side. Good looking shot for Kevin Vino. And the lead is 30. 118-88. No luck for Riley Robinson. Trouser just missing. McIntyre dribbles it off his foot. Power takes it for two. 120-88. Fleming can't finish. Cole Pitts was there. He'll get the foul. Under 3 minutes to go. Fleming misses the front end. Vino. Fleming missed both. Intercepts the pass there. And gets a foul on Crusher at the same time. Robinson passes on the elbow jumper, sets up the three for Whittem. Nicely done. 120-92. Actually, one of two there for Fleming. And now with the three, this is a four-point run here for MBR. Vino. That just rims out for William Pulpitz. It was definitely a day for Campbell Culpitz, 26 points. Chase Tynes will exit. Once again, he was a menace defensively. Fleming. Trying to go against Crusher. Foul on the floor, a baseline inbounds. Nicely done on a three for Whittem. Two threes in a row. And a seven-point run here for MBR. 120-95. Muse. Culpitz. Good adjustment and finish for William. Whittem. It's a step on Culpitz. Finishes inside. 8 points in a row now for Isaac. 122-97. Tough play inside. Jack Campbell. There's Fleming. Back and forth they go, exchanging baskets. Fleming up and under for two. A point away from the century mark is Maine. Nice look, William Culpitz. And traveling on Culpitz as he came back down with it. Getting a big mitt on it was Fleming. $24.99. Nice backdoor cut. Chasse for three. Off the front iron. 45 seconds remaining. Nice pass. Vino to Culpitz. Might have got away with the travel. Can't finish, but he'll go to the line. Foul shot miss for Culpitz. $125.99. Here's Whittem. Robinson. Chasse. Fleming. Trying to go back and forth with McIntyre, but the angle on the pass disappeared there. One more possession for basketball Nova Scotia. Crusher knocked away by Whittem. Still 15 on the shot clock. Up top to Muse. 10 on the shot clock. William Culpitz, the three for Jack Campbell. Well, that's going to do it. 8 seconds remaining. One more possession for Maine. Nova Scotia, pretty dominant throughout. Maine will hit the century mark. At one point, MBR got it down to five, but just could not get any closer. And Nova Scotia, Maine ready to shake hands here. Nova Scotia, as I was saying, pretty dominant throughout the tournament. An outstanding effort as well from Maine. As just could not get over that hump. And again, as you saw the fourth quarter, the third quarter turned into the fourth quarter. Just looked like the legs really ran out on this Maine team. Again, only three players on the bench. And Nova Scotia running all 12 guys, putting the pressure on, getting out in transition. Defensive intensity. And they really stretched out that lead. It'll finish up 125-101. A lot of fun here today at the Fieldhouse. Fleming finishes with 33. Cole Pitts had 24. Carson had 24. Darling had 20. We'll see if the microphone works here for Ben Morrison. If it does, we'll let him take over.
All right.
It does. Okay. Here's Ben Morrison.
As all the other games this weekend, this is the first annual East Coast Games. Six sporting events happening around St. John and you know, the community, and basketball being one of them. And last year, there was talk about basketball being part of that, bringing in the best players in the Maritimes and then from Maine as well. And we've been able to do that, so it's been a huge success. So a big round of applause for the two teams that are here in front of us. Nova Scotia basketball is getting better and better and better every year. And I have heard endless great things about MBR over the years, and we're very proud and happy to have you guys travel up from Southern Maine and come up to St. John's, so we really appreciate it. So we're going to go ahead. So we're going to start with the silver medals. I call it the silver medals going to MBR. We're going to start with number three, Tom Coyne. Number five, Nick Chase. Number 12, Isaac Witham. Number 20, Connor Moore. Number 30, Hunter Smith. Number 32, Andrew Fleming. I have to say, Andrew, phenomenal basketball player. Great work. Number 33, Riley Robinson. And I want to give a huge thanks. I know I spoke often for the past couple of months to Rick Moore about bringing MBR up. He was very thankful to him. And to the coaches, James Robinson and Kevin Black. So once again, we're very thankful for our first annual East Coast Games to have MBR come up from Southern Maine. Coach and I talked earlier about half of my family living in Caribou, Prescott, Portland, Maine. And, so that's really important to me to have that connection with Maine and New Brunswick. So that's huge. So thank you so much for coming. Next up, we're going to present the medals to the gold medals to Nova Scotia basketball. So first, number two, Tristan High. Number three, Rowan Power. Nate Darling. Number seven, Brunel Johnson. Number eight, Campbell Pulpitz. Number nine, number 10, Chase Steins. Number 10, Keenan Vito. Number 12, Jack Campbell. Number 13, Alex Carson. And I know Nova Scotia's got a pretty good coaching staff, so we're going to give medals to all of them. Hold your minute. Number 14, Will Pulpitz. It possible. just before you leave, if we could get a picture of, actually it'd be nice if the two teams side by side, is that okay, coaches? Just for the picture with the banner? Awesome.
All right, what a great sight. That's what it's all about right there, coming together. In this case of different countries. Of course, side by side here, Atlanta, Canada, and Maine. Basketball, Nova Scotia, and MBR. A great game. Basketball, Nova Scotia pulls away in the end. But really a great game throughout, featuring phenomenal talent on both sides. A great way to finish off the tournament. And the East Coast Games, what a time we've had here on Bell Aliant Community One, webcasting all the events. Thanks for being with us throughout the entire weekend. Thanks to everybody with the East Coast Games for taking such good care of us, and our friends here at UNBSJ as well. Ben Morrison and the outstanding staff here with the East Coast Games basketball venue. You've been watching a live presentation of Bell Aliant Community One, the leader in local sports webcasting in Atlanta, Canada. The East Coast Games from St. John, New Brunswick. Nova Scotia wins gold in the U17 boys division with a 125-101 final score over MBR. But an incredible tournament for everybody. Good times all around. We will talk to you soon on Bell Aliant Community One. But for now, goodbye from beautiful St. John, New Brunswick.